I think the use of psychiatric treatment, so-called treatment, as a political weapon is very effective in controlling the masses. The Soviets were very expert on incarcerating their political dissidents. They would either send them to concentration camps up in the Arctic Circle where they would be worked to death, or in many cases they'd put them into psychiatric wards and punish them. They would punish them with drugs, electric shock, and that sort of thing. I think the example that we see in China today is very instructive. China is a good or a bad example, depending on how you look at it. I say it's a good example because it shows us how a totalitarian regime can use psychiatry as a political weapon to discipline and torture, literally, and frighten people into submission. What's happening here in the United States seems to be following in the same footsteps of the path that's already been taken in China. There's something called the Mayak Report, a very secret report issued to law enforcement agencies in which they said, beware, anybody that's opposed to the income tax is talking about defending the Constitution or supported a third-party political candidate. Individual freedoms are going down while government power and control is going up. And you just lay a mental ruler along that graph in your mind for the last 20 or 30, 40 years and project it into the future, and you can see where it's going. If we were to have a mandatory mental health screening, as they like to call it, not only of all of the young people in school, but all adults and everybody, it would become a terribly effective tool in the hands of totalitarians. Because surely you could find something in everybody's questionnaire if they answer questions honestly. Have you ever had feelings of anxiety? Are you ever unhappy with what the government does? You put that in the context of what everything else that's happening in society, the growth of government, the growth of big government, the diminishing of personal freedoms, the desire to regiment the population and eliminate opposition to the political leaders. And we put it into that picture, and now it takes on a very special meaning. When you look at the area of psychiatry, it becomes particularly worrisome, because many people are not sensitized to the political implications of using that field. If we're not willing to challenge, and if we're already afraid that somebody's going to put this label around us, then we've already lost. There's no turning it around. The time has come for us to stand on our convictions, to know what is right, to take the risks, and stand for freedom.